This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain Lenz's law. Apply Lenz's law in order to indicate the direction of the induced current.
Before explaining Lenz's law, let's remind you with the magnetic field created by a current-carrying solenoid. Look at the figure. It shows the magnetic field lines inside and outside the solenoid. The solenoid has two faces that act as magnetic poles. So we have the north face and the south face. Now, we care about the magnetic field lines inside the solenoid. Inside the solenoid and away from its ends, the field lines are nearly parallel to its axis, which means that the magnetic field inside the solenoid is considered to be uniform. These lines are directed from the south face to the north face, but these lines form closed loops, so outside the solenoid, they radiate outward from the north pole and converge inward toward the south pole. Now, we want the expression of the magnitude of the magnetic field inside the solenoid. So it is given by this expression, 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 7 Ni over L. Take into account that this expression is valid if the solenoid is placed in air, as in our experiment. Now, N is the number of loops, I is the current carried by the solenoid, and L is the length of the solenoid. So this is the length of the solenoid. Now, we want to determine the direction of the magnetic field created by the solenoid inside it. The direction of the magnetic field inside the solenoid is specified using the right-hand rule. You curl the fingers of your right hand with the direction of the current, then your thumb would point in the direction of the magnetic field inside the solenoid. Now, the right-hand rule is explained in details in the next experiment.
This experiment is about the determination of the magnetic field created by a current inside a solenoid or at the center of a loop. Let's start with the solenoid. The current in the solenoid as shown. So, we curl the fingers of the right hand in the sense of the current. The thumb points to the direction of the magnetic field. So, using the right hand rule, the magnetic field inside the solenoid is directed horizontally to the left. Before moving to the second case, what do we mean by the solid and the dashed lines? If you look directly at the solenoid, you can see only half of the loops, on only half of each loop. The parts of the loop that can be seen are represented by solid lines, and the other parts are represented by dashed lines. Now, in this case, the axis of the solenoid extends along the vertical. So the magnetic field could be vertically upward or vertically downward. Using the right-hand rule, we curl the fingers of the right hand in the sense of the current. As you see, the thumb points vertically upward. So the magnetic field created inside the solenoid is directed vertically upward. Now, let's study the magnetic field created by a current at the center of a loop. This loop is placed in the horizontal plane. At the center of the loop, as that of the solenoid, we curl the fingers of the right hand in the sense of the current. The thumb points to the direction of the magnetic field. As you see, the thumb is directed vertically downward, so the current at the center, the magnetic field at the center of the loop is directed vertically downward. In this case, the loop is placed in the vertical plane, and the current as shown. So we curl the fingers of the right hand with the sense of the current. As you see, the thumb points to the left. So the magnetic field created by the current at the center of the loop is directed horizontally to the left.
Let's Let's move to Lenz's law. In the previous episode, we discussed the electromagnetic induction phenomenon, which is the induction of a potential difference or electromotive force E in a conductor when it is placed in a varying magnetic flux. Also, if the circuit of the conductor is closed, then this conductor carries an induced current. Lenz's law helps us to determine the direction of this induced current. So, when an electromotive force is induced due to a variation in the magnetic flux, the direction of the induced current is such that its magnetic effects oppose the cause that produces it. Let me explain the law. What do we mean by oppose the cause that produces it? The current is directed in such a way as to oppose the change in the magnetic flux. Now, what do we mean by magnetic effects? For example, when the conductor carries an induced current, it produces its own magnetic field, which is called the induced magnetic field. Now, the induced magnetic field is one of the magnetic effects of the induced current. Also, when this conductor carries the induced current and at the same time it is placed in an external magnetic field, so it is acted upon by Laplace force. Laplace force is one of the magnetic effects of the induced current. Now, we will give you some examples to apply Lenz's law in order to determine the direction of the induced current.
First example, a bar magnet is approaching a coil. Determine the direction of the induced current in this coil. The direction of this current can be determined using three steps. First step, we identify the poles of the faces of the solenoid. Second step, we determine the direction of the induced magnetic field due to the current inside the solenoid. And the third step, we use the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. Now, the cause that produces the current in the solenoid is the motion of the magnet. So, according to Lenz's law, the right face of the coil acts as a north pole to repel the approaching north pole of the magnet or to resist the motion of the magnet. Then, the left face of the coil should act as a south pole. As you know, the magnetic field inside the solenoid created by the current is directed from the south to the north. So B induced is directed horizontally to the right. Now we use the right hand rule. We know the direction of the magnetic field, which is directed from left to right. So the thumb of your right hand should be directed to the right, and you must curl the fingers of your right hand in the shown direction of the current. So we can conclude that the induced current in the coil is directed from left to right.
Now let's determine the direction of the induced current using another method. In this method, we will focus on the magnitude of the magnetic field of the bar magnet at all points inside the coil. Now, during the motion of the bar magnet towards the coil, the magnitude of the magnetic field B increases at all points inside the coil. So the induced magnetic field created by the induced current must be horizontal to the right in order to oppose the increase in the magnitude of the external magnetic field. Now, let's apply the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. So, we curl the fingers of our right hand and the thumb must point horizontally to the right. So, the fingers are curled in the direction of the current, which is shown on the figure. So, according to the right-hand rule, the coil carries an induced current from left to right.
Second example. Now, the bar magnet is moving away from the coil. Determine the direction of the induced current in the coil. In this case, the right face of the coil acts as a south pole to attract the north pole of the magnet or to resist the motion of the magnet, then the left face of the coil acts as a north pole. Therefore, the magnetic field inside the solenoid is directed horizontally to the left. Finally, we use the right-hand rule. If we curl the fingers of the right hand in the shown direction of the current, the thumb points to the left. Therefore, the induced current in the coil is directed from right to left.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to application 3. In this application, a bar magnet is rotated by 90 degrees in an anticlockwise sense beside a vertical conducting loop. The second figure shows the magnet after rotating the 90 degrees. Now, look at the vertical conducting loop. This is the right face of the loop and this is the left face of the loop. Now, during the rotation of the magnet, its south pole approaches the right face of the loop. So, the right face of the loop acts then as a south pole to repel the approaching south pole of the bar magnet. Now, if the right face is a south pole, so the left face acts as a north pole, and the direction of the induced magnetic field created by the induced current at the center of the loop is horizontal to the left. Now let's apply the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. Curl the fingers of your right hand and your thumb must indicate or must point horizontally to the left. So if the thumb points horizontally to the left, then your fingers are curled in this direction, which is the direction of the induced current as shown on the figure. Now, if you are looking at the loop from this side, you will say that the current flows in the loop clockwise, while if you are looking at the loop from this side, you will say that the current flows counterclockwise. Before moving to the last application, let's remind you with the Laplace force. Look at the figure. You have a straight conductor which carries an electric current I, and it is placed in a horizontal magnetic field whose direction is inwards. Now, a straight conductor of length L carrying a current I and placed in a uniform external magnetic field B is acted upon by a magnetic force called Laplace force. So this is Laplace force. Now, the expression of Laplace force is I L cross B. I is the current carried by the conductor. L is the vector representing the straight wire oriented in the direction of I, and B is the magnetic field. Let's move to the characteristics of the Laplace force. Point of application, the midpoint of the straight conductor. So as you see in the figure, the Laplace force is drawn from the midpoint. Line of action, it is perpendicular to the plane formed by the conductor and the magnetic field vector. So in the figure, the magnetic field B, and it is horizontal, and the conductor are both placed in the horizontal plane. And the Laplace force is vertical, so it is perpendicular to this plane. Let's move to the direction. The direction of the Laplace force obeys the right-hand rule. Look at the second figure. The second figure explains the right-hand rule. The thumb of the right hand points in the direction of the current. The other fingers point in the direction of the magnetic field. The direction of the magnetic force or Laplace force is then away from the palm of the hand. In the third figure, we have another right-hand rule, which is very similar to the one explained in the second figure. The right-hand rule is explained in details in the next experiment. Now let's move to the magnitude of the Laplace force. The magnitude of the cross product of two vectors is the product of the magnitudes of the two vectors times the sine of the angle between them. So the magnitude of the Laplace force is I times L times B times sine the angle between L and B.
This experiment is about the determination of the direction of the Laplace force using the right-hand rule. Recall that when a straight conductor carrying a current and placed in an external magnetic field, this conductor is acted upon by a magnetic force called the Laplace force, and in some references, this force is called the electromagnetic force. To determine the direction of this force, we use the right hand as shown. The thumb of your right hand points in the sense of the current, the index finger points in the direction of the magnetic field, and the middle finger points in the direction of the Laplace force. Also, we have another method using the right hand to determine the direction of this force. We use the right hand as shown. The thumb points in the sense of the current, the other fingers point on the direction of the magnetic field, and the Laplace force is directed away from the palm of the hand. Now, the palm of my right hand faces this side, so the Laplace force is directed towards this side. If the palm of my right hand faces the ground, so the Laplace force is directed vertically downward. Now, let's take some examples using Laplace rings. In this case, the current in the rod is directed from C to D, and the magnetic field is directed vertically downward. Now, this is Laplace race. The current from C to D and B is directed vertically downward. So the thumb now points in the sense of the current, which is inward. Magnetic field downward, so the other fingers directed vertically downward. As you see, the palm of my right hand faces the left side. So the direction of the Laplace force is to the left. In this case, the current is directed in the rod from D to C, but Laplace rays now making an angle alpha with the horizontal. The magnetic field B is normal to the plane of the Laplace rays, but directed upward. So, now the current is directed from D to C, and B is directed upward. So, my right hand faces the bottom of the Laplace rays. So, B or F is directed towards the bottom of the rays, and F is drawn from the midpoint of the rod CD.
Let's move to the last application. In this application, a conducting rod MN forms a closed circuit with an ammeter A while placed between the poles of a U-shaped magnet. The rod is given an initial velocity which is directed horizontally to the right. Now we want to determine the direction of the induced current. Now, the magnetic flux changes and the current is induced in the circuit because the rod moves horizontally to the right. So, the direction of the Laplace force which is created must be horizontal to the left in order to oppose the motion of the rod to the right. Now let's apply the right hand rule. So prepare your right hand. Your thumb makes a 90 degrees with the other fingers. The other fingers are vertical upward or point vertical upward in the direction of B. The palm of your hand faces the left side, so your thumb points outwards or from M to N. So according to the right hand rule, the induced current flows clockwise in the circuit, or you can say rod MN carries an electric current from M to N.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.